Hi friends, my name is Akil Ahmed and in this particular video tutorial I will show you how to load current date file into the SQL Server table. So this is my profile. I have 13 plus years of experience on Microsoft technologies. So the agenda of today's video tutorial is how to load only current date file into the SQL Server table. So recently I got a question from one of my subscriber Durga Prasad that before processing the file you have to validate the file is today's date or not. If the file is today's date, then we have to process the file, or else we need to reject the file and send an email notification. So today we will see how we can achieve this thing. So let's jump to the demo. On my machine in the D files folder, I have two files, emails underscore 2021-09-20 and then 2021-09-22. So this file contains some email data, and maybe I can show you what kind of data it has. So it has simple I like ID, first name, last name, email and gender, this information. So I want to process only current date file regardless whatever number of files are present in this particular folder. So today is 9/22, so this second file should be processed and first file should not be processed. So I will be loading this particular file into my emails table on the SQL Server database. And there is a database SSIS, so I want to load that file into this table. So right now this table is empty, as you can see. So let me open the Visual Studio and write the code. So this is my Visual Studio 2019 that I will be using to write the code. So because we are going to loop through multiple files, so we will be using the for each loop container to do that. So first of all, let me declare two SSIS variables. First variable I will call it is like file path, and data type will be string. And I will give the path of one of the file here. It's not necessary, but I'm just going to do that just for validation purpose. So let me just put file path. And now I need to declare one more variable, which will be load file. I mean, should we load the file or not load the file? And the data type will be string, and the value can be, for example, no or yes. So you can put any value here. The value to the load file SSIS variable will be assigned in the SSIS package itself. Okay. So we have declared two SSIS variables. Now what we need to do, we need to declare a for each loop container here. So I will write for each loop. Okay. And now we can just configure this for each loop container. So in the collection, in the enumerator, we will select the for each file enumerator as we are going to process the CSV files, and then we can browse the folder, which folder we want to browse through. So this is the folder, D files folder. I want to browse CSV file, so I can just change the extension to CSV. Now in the variable mapping, I can just select the file path SSIS variables. So for each iteration, the current value of the file path will be assigned to this file path SSIS variable. Just click OK. So we have configured the for each loop container. Now the first task that we will be using is the script task. So in script task, we will actually check whether to process the file or not process the file. So just drag and drop the script task into the for each loop container, and maybe we can call it like check if to process the file. We can call like this, and then we can configure it. In the read only variables, we will select the file path SSIS variable because we want to check the date of the current file. And in the read write variable, we will select the load file. So load file will be assigned with two values, either yes or no. Okay, now click on edit script. We will write the code in the script task. So there can be multiple ways to achieve this particular thing, like maybe we can use expressions as well, SSIS expressions, but I thought that that might be tricky as compared to the script task. So that's why I'm using the script task here. Okay, so in the namespaces, we need to add a namespace using system.io. Okay, and then in this location, add your code here. What we can do is, I have already written this particular code just to save some time. I will explain you what we are doing here. So in this particular line, we are declaring a file path SSIS variable and then getting the value of the file path SSIS variable. And now in the file name, we are just getting the file name without extension from the file path. And now in this particular line, we are getting whatever value is after the underscore. So after underscore, there is a date. So we are getting the date value in this particular line and assigning to date value. And in this line, we are just getting the today's date in this particular format. YYYMMDD. Now we are simply checking if the date value from the file path is equal to the today's date, then we will set the local variable file load file with yes. Otherwise, we will assign the value no to the load file local variable, string variable. Once this value has been assigned either yes or no, so if the file date will match with the current date, then the yes value will be assigned, and if the file date with the today's date won't match, then a no value will be assigned to the load file local variable, and that value we are finally assigning to the SSIS variable load file. So that's the only thing that we are doing here. Okay, so after this code, a value yes or no will be assigned to the load file based on the value from the file path. So just click OK. Now here we need to do two kind of thing. If the value matches, then we need to load the file. So to load a file, we can use the data flow task. So just drag and drop the data flow task and then connect the script task with the data flow task, and we can just double click on it, and in the expression and constants, in the expressions we can write load file equal to yes. So if this will click on invalid expression, so this is okay because the current value we have set to load file is no in the SSIS variables, that's why it is being evaluated as false. So we are checking if the load file will be yes, then this part to click OK, this particular code will be executed. So we will load the file in this particular task. We will be using the flat file source to read the file. So just configure the flat file source, browse the file. We can select any file because this value will be assigned from the SSIS variable. So this seems good. Maybe I can put text qualifier as double quote. Click OK. OK. And then we will be using the OLTP destination to write the data into the SQL Server table. And configure this one. Create a new connection. So I already have a connection to the SSIS database. Just select the table or view fast load. And I can select the emails table. Click on mapping. So mapping seems good here. Click OK. Now to make the connection dynamic, we can click on this one, flat file connection manager, and then go to the properties of it, and the expressions we can select the connection string property, and we can assign the value from the file path. So this connection is now dynamic, so it can process any file. So if the value of the load file will be yes, then we will process this file. And the another condition is if the value of the load file is no, then we need to send the email. So there are different ways to send the email. For example, we can send the email from send mail task, or we can use C# script task code to send the email as well. So I have already shown you how we can send the email. So maybe I will share the link in the description of this particular video. But right now I don't have the SMTP server configured on my laptop. Normally it's being done in a company by IT, so I don't have the SMTP server, so that's why I can't use the send mail task now. So what I can do, I can just show you that, for example, if the value will be no, then how we can configure it, and maybe I can call it like send email. I can put a breakpoint here so that you can see that for which file. If the file is today's date, then where the control is going, and if the file is not current date, then where the control is going. Okay, so I will show you that thing. Just configure this one, double click on it, change to expression and constants. In the expressions, we can drag and drop load file equal to no. So if it is equal to no, so this got evaluated true because the current value is no in the SSIS variable. Click OK. Okay, so we have configured it. Now let me put a breakpoint, one breakpoint here on pre-execute and one breakpoint here on pre-execute, so that I know when the SSIS package will run, so for which file the control will go to which location. So remember today is 9:22. Okay, so now let me just execute the SSIS package. Click on start. Alright, so it did not process the file. So let me see what file it is going to process. So you can click on debug, Windows, locals, and in the variables there is a variable file path. So file path should contain the file name. So it is trying to process the 920 file, but because today is 922, so that's why it did not process the file. Now let me continue running this SSIS package for next file. So now you saw that for next file it actually going to load the file, because right now today is 9:22. So let me just continue it. So it will load 1000 records. So if you double click on it, it loaded 1000 records to the SQL Server table, because it was the current file. And you can check the data in the SQL Server table as well. It loaded 1000 records. So in this particular directory we can have n number of files, but RSSIS package will only load the current date file using this method. Thank you guys for watching the video, and if you like the video then please click the like button, do subscribe to our channel, press the bell icon and click on all so that you will be notified every time I upload a new video. Thank you so much.